That was awesome. I love it. This, we're not thinking crazy enough.
Well, I can assure you that my moonshots are better than my presentation skills.
We went from not believing that heavier than air flight was possible to walking on the moon.
I've always been puzzled that when my cell phone runs out of power, why can't I just shake it a little bit and then continue the call? Say, one moment, please. Okay, what were we saying?
What we're talking about is a profound way of thinking, a whole paradigm change on antenna technology.
Our consumption has exponentially increased, but what's equally increased is the obsolescence rate. And we call this the dark side of Moore's Law.
What's the moonshot? The moonshot is to do that without destroying the planet.
This doesn't sound so crackpot anymore. We're getting close. We just have to up the resolution by 100x.
Really cool moonshots about displays and imaging and the future of visual communications.
This is a tactile array on the exterior of a glove. So the surgeon now can have sensors in their finger that allows them to sense in real time what's going on the heart.
And the people that I find most interesting, modeled after Larry and Sergey, are people who want to change the world.
And what's really interesting is you're getting high school kids and college kids thinking about how do you begin to assemble simple, standard, interchangeable parts in living cells.
But there's actually one interface on the surface of the body that can literally provide us with a window of what happens inside.
Well, where does that take us next? And how much computational capability does each of our phones in our pockets have?
You know, there's going to be public perception issues. It's called changing the world. Is it worth it?
We think absolutely.
And when you think about it, it's sort of logical. A cow is not the most efficient transducer of solar energy into protein nutrition.
We can actually get biodiesel right out of a plant.
And the best thing about living things is that they can scale to meet our global challenges.
There are so many moonshots here. I think the trouble we have is ranking them.
The hardest problems can be solved by simple solutions.
Let's not talk about the things that we might build. Let's start building them and designing them and advancing them and imagining them and writing stories about them and changing the way that people learn and changing the way that people think.
And a society that solves these problems together might be more likely to implement the required changes together.